Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome. You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others. Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing.
Dead.
It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting closer.
They're watching.
They're watching. They're watching. They're watching.
This is a journey deep into darkness. There'll be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why isn't she coming?
She's doing this for him.
She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh. You're coming.
Quiet. Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. Well, that's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Look around you. Can you see them over there?
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
He's in hell.
Look, up ahead. You see it too?
You promised you can.
Yes, it is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell. Look around and you'll see them. The drowned, the sick, the slain. Here they lie, rotting in the fields and rivers of hell. But the dead don't always lie still here. This is not a place of rest.
I can't do this. Go back, go back. They're going to do that to you. Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her. bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Then it was fear runs far, far deeper. Too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know. Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
She needs to focus now.
She needs to use her eyes. Knives across which lies the halls of hell, the place they call Helheim.
He's lost.
Where are you?
There's no doubt about
it.
The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
He's already dead.
His soul is in Helheim. His soul still lives. She needs to save his soul.
She wants his soul to be at peace.
She needs to lay him to rest.
The bridge to Helheim. I forget its name. She forgets too.
But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we? This is it. The hidden path.
Truth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell if I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
Come closer.
She can't focus.
Why aren't she looking closer?
Take a closer look, Senua.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate.
Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's fine?
Let it work.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell. But I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listened? When everyone else laughed. My people. carry my stories with you, and together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are always here. I guess it's the same with heights. Stand on the edge. Pretend it's going to be okay. But you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the 9 worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed, and with her you must bargain.
The gate to Helheim divides the living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him.
Agnes is coming. I'll tell you it's her. Get it.
go.
Vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not real.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Hela, to Dillian.
To his soul. It won't open.
How will she get through?
Why won't it open?
Why can't she open it? She needs to challenge the gods.
She has to fight two gods first.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice. Surt, the fire giant, has answered. He comes from a land older than mankind. And the Northmen call upon his flaming sword to raise their enemies to the ground. Find him, Senua, and spill his blood.
She found the wretched old fool on her way back from the wilds. An outcast. He was badly burnt all over. She took pity on him, for he was not long for this world. Like her, who spoke of his own darkness. The Northmen.
Northmen tell this story. Before the Earth was created, there was a world called Muspel. Because it was in the south, it was bright and hot, flaming, burning. Sparks that flew out from Muspel became the stars. Other sparks melted ice in the frozen world of Niflheim, creating the body of the first giant, Ymir. Muspel is one of the nine worlds, and is now the land of fire giants. And people from elsewhere cannot endure a journey there.
Senua, we each walk these lands, gazing towards different horizons, some of us further than others. Your father cannot see what you see, but there is nothing wrong with seeing the world the way you do.
Human flesh. And I still hear their cries carried in the wind. Do you hear them too, Senua?
Yes, I heard their screams, and I still hear them now.
Thank you. hear the runes.
Focus.
The path to Helheim is sealed to the living, but you already walk amongst the dead. Look towards the gate, and you will see that it has opened. Enough of their tongue to beg for mercy, and they took me as a slave. I wish now that they had slaughtered me like the others. I rode their storm of fire, death, and slavery to many lands. This darkness you speak of? I know it well.
And I'm still here to fight it.
Another way.
Find another path.
There's always a way.
Find your own way.
You just have to find it.
Sert is waiting for you.
It was never going to be that easy.
He's waiting. Sert
is waiting for you.
Find him.
The pyre.
The Northmen say that the defender of Muspel is called Sert, the foremost of the fire giants. His name means the Black One, because he is like something burnt. The Northmen believe that he sits at the border of Muspel with his flaming sword, and at the end of the world he will leave his post.
Another gate.
Another gate.
She needs to find it.
Another fire sacrifice.
Another fire sacrifice.
Find the fire, Senua, to follow the path to Surt.
It's too far.
She'll never find it. She'll never make her way back.
She needs to remember the way back.
What happens when she finds it?
Everything will burn.
Concentrate. Concentrate on where you're going.
She needs to remember the path.
Everything will burn. Then how will she find the way back?
She won't. She won't be able to tell.
The Northmen made fire sacrifices, burning slaves like me to reveal the path to Surt. I searched for meaning in their suffering, in their eyes, but they just screamed like helpless pigs.
Answer your prayers, Senua. I asked the gods for mercy, all of them, even theirs. None answered. In the end, I set myself free. Defy the gods, Senua! Find your own path, like I find mine!
My gods abandoned me! I am alone.
Northmen of Hell worship the Devourers, insatiable gods of darkness. I come from Erin, Senua, where I once followed my own gods, the Tuatha De Danann.
Why did you abandon your gods?
Senua, I was a man of knowledge, not a warrior. To survive, I did things. Bad things. Like you, Senua.
man I once was has died. And when that happens, even gods you worship can die with you. The Northmen believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by Surt and the Fire Giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against their enemies. There is nothing they can do to prevent it, but Odin ever seeks knowledge and magic, hoping to find a way to postpone that dark day. Northmen believe that the world will be destroyed someday. They call it Ragnarok, the destiny of the gods. Asgard will be attacked by Surt and the Fire Giants. A monstrous wolf will swallow the sun, and the gods will fight in vain against their enemies. There is nothing they can do to prevent it, but Odin ever seeks knowledge and magic, hoping to find a way to postpone that dark day.
did this! This is your... Stop! Tell me, Drew, how did you escape your darkness?
Senua, once I found my purpose, I was no longer enslaved to the suffering I had to endure to reach it. Unclouded by fear, I could see it clearly in others. Even my captors feared the fire of Surt. And so, during one raid,
I took my chance. I ran, knowing that they would not follow. A fool ran into the fire. They left me for dead. Maybe they were right. But here I am. Free.
I'm glad I found you in the wilds. I wouldn't have made it without you.
The Northmen say that at Ragnarok, the sons of Muspel will travel to battle in the ship called Naglfar, the corpse ship. And when the sons of Muspel leave the ship and ride to battle, it will be as though the sky had split open, and Surt will lead them. Wherever he goes, flame will erupt before him, and fires will burn behind him.